Hello everyone, welcome to AgriViews, our video blog which covers everything related to agriculture. We cover trade, technology, innovation and policy. Today's topic is very important for everyone who is practicing in domain of international agriculture. Africa. And why do we say it is the last frontier of agriculture development? For that, we'll have to understand two more economies. First, China. From 1940s, 50s, 60s, and 70s, and India from 60s, 70s, and 80s. In the fourth decade of China, and three decades in India, there were three very important parameters. One, the gross value addition by agriculture was stagnant for this period. Off-farm incomes were as good as nothing for the farmers. And third, the increase in productivity, hence income of the farmer, was also nearly flat. Now, you would say, why we are talking about China and India when we are discussing Africa? The reason is, in 70s, 80s, 90s and early 2000, Africa was also going through the same pattern. However, in early 80s or late 70s, China changed their policy. Similarly, in early 90s, India changed their policy. Both of the countries took reform in their economy. And what was the result? If you see, for subsequent past 2.5 decades, China has been able to achieve the agriculture GDP growth of on average 4.5%. Similarly, India achieved for past 2.5 decades growth of close to 3%. Now, can the same pattern be repeated in Africa? What has happened since 2018, where the African Union initiated a proposal to create a Africa Continental Free Trade Area, which was ratified by close to 35 odd countries and which have 54 countries participating in it, was triggered on 1st of January 2021. And we have seen in past 1.5 months already there are positive impact of that. It is estimated that $1 trillion would be added to GDP of Africa over a decade because of just this one policy act where Africa got united, creating an integrated one market for Africa. This also helped in enhancing the inter-country trade within Africa. It is estimated by end of 2022, 60% increase would be seen in inter-country trade within Africa, with majority of country agreeing to remove tariff for 90% of the producers. It's a very positive sign for everyone who is involved in business, trade, investment in Africa, and more importantly, those who believe agriculture would create growth opportunities in Africa. So let us first understand a little bit of why Africa is having such a great potential. First, the population on Africa would rise from 1.3 billion in 2019 to close to 2.5 billion in 2050. We are seeing that the additional population growth globally would be hugely impacted by Africa, it contributing 60% of population growth by 2100. One thing of importance here is that the average age of Africa is 27%, with close to 78% people falling in working class 16 to 60 band. That means more hands, more brains to work. Second, the GDP of Africa is estimated to grow between 4.5% to 5% over next 3 decades. Since 2011, it is already above the world average by 100 basis points. But going forward, it is estimated that Africa would be growing faster than any region, whether it is Asia, Europe or Latin America. Third, the agriculture productivity is estimated to increase by 260% because of various factors. One, technology. Second, investment. In fact, Africa, which is currently investing close to $9 billion in agriculture economy this year, is expected to pump in close to $360 billion over a span of 10 to 15 years. All this will increase productivity of agriculture in Africa. Fourth point, while there would be reduction in share of agriculture in Africa's GDP from 23% to 16% over past next 3 decades, but the fall in number of people involved in agriculture is going to go down from 65% to 40%. What that means is very simply increase in per capita income of farmers of Africa, because a substantial part of existing farmers will move out in other activities like service and manufacturing, creating more sustainable environment for African farmers. Finally, current connectivity, digital connectivity in Africa is around 40%. Within a decade's time, it is gonna be close to 88%. With more Africans having access to digital connectivity through their smartphones, there would be substantial increase in those services and activities which are influenced by digital business. Companies like Facebook, Google, and even public sector and multilateral agencies like African Development Bank, they are investing heavily in making Africa more connected. Now let us understand a little bit about agriculture in Africa. So if you see that there are close to 41.5 million farms in Africa, and 80% of them are small farms with less than 2 hectare land holding. There are 351 million hectares of cultivated arable land in Africa. Now beauty here is that Africa is having 60% non-cultivated arable land in world, which is very important to understand for a basic fact that with 200 million hectares of arable land only available worldwide, Africa would be the future of food security for not just the continent itself, but the world. $50 billion is food which is imported from outside the continent in Africa. A continent which was food sufficient in 1960s, today is importing heavily the food product. There are various reasons for that. One is the excessive subsidies given by European economy and USA for cereal crops, typically wheat and rice, which makes the produce of Africa economically costlier than those imported from these developed countries. However, going forward, we are seeing that because of inter-country trade, because of enhanced productivity, Africa would be able to substantially reduce their input bill for food products. There is 333 million severely food insecure people in Africa. Now also, the African Free Trade Area would bring a lot of people out of poverty, close to 100 million people out of severe or mid-level poverty in Africa, making them capable of having better access to food and hence becoming more food secure. There are 243 million undernourished people in Africa. Now that has been trend for a long, long time because of various factors, including political instability, civil wars, low economic growth. All of these are the reason which has created a lot of hunger, starvation, and malnutrition in Africa. Now, when you see this holistically, this creates a possibility where there is huge demand, ripe to be grabbed by Africans because of positive policy framework now created to integrate Africa as one uniform economy. Let us understand what are those opportunities. The first is irrigation technology. If you see the water stress, which is being seen in India and China, has been because of wrong policy of not regulating groundwater, at the same time giving subsidy on electricity, leading to abuse of water in agriculture. Africa can learn from that. However, if you see current scenario, the Central, Eastern, and Western Africa is blessed with good rainfall. However, the southern part of Africa and northern part of Africa is severely deficient when it comes to rain. Same is where the availability of groundwater or the rivers, basin, as well as lakes in Africa, they are more or less concentrated towards Central, Eastern, and Western Africa. This means Africa need to be more careful in planning their irrigation. First thing is, there is opportunity for services related to weather forecast, so that farmers can plan right crops based on the weather, which is predicted. Second, the water resource management. With Africa blessed with long rivers and some of the largest lakes, it needs to plan its water resources more efficiently, and a lot of technology intervention using remote sensing, using AI and ML tools can help Africa ensure their agriculture never run out of water, the problem faced by economies like China and India. Then micro irrigation. Unfortunately, only 5% of Africa's farms are irrigated. This leads to a lot of wastage of water and reduced productivity. To ensure more and more farms are having efficient irrigation, Africa need to come out aggressively to create micro irrigation solutions and policies framework to encourage micro irrigation. And finally, precision agriculture. Once you are having micro irrigation based on the type of crop, the right schedules and requirement of water should be assessed, and the infrastructure for irrigation should be created based on facts and scientific data rather than assumptions. If Africa can save its water, future is very bright when it comes to agriculture in Africa. The second opportunity is about digital agriculture. Africa has been, unfortunately, a continent where the farmers on average make $3 a day and $500 per hectare annually. These are the lowest productivity globally. Africa can come out of this low productivity trap by using data. Data for right planning of agriculture, what crop based on demand, when to sow, when to harvest, the crop planning, financing. Africa is having huge shortfall when it comes to financing of farmers. A data-driven approach to that will ensure the creditworthiness can be evaluated fast and farmers can be provided with credit on a real-time basis. Then the market access. Any continent which is so broad need to have right visibility of demand generation and access for farmers to those market. Data-driven aggregation, data-driven logistic can go a long way in making farmers of Africa more profitable. And finally, policy making. The time of making policy based on assumption is over. Now, the governments in Africa need to make policy based on hard facts and data. And this creates huge opportunity for digital agriculture in Africa. Close to 60 million farmers are already leveraging digital agriculture tools in Africa, but we need far more scalability so that close to 40 to 50% of African farmers can have access to digital agriculture. The market for digital agriculture in Africa currently, which is close to $2.1 billion, is estimated to grow at average of close to 18 to 19% year on year basis, creating huge opportunities for all tech companies from across the globe. The last opportunity is in agronomy. Unfortunately, because of low productivity, low income, the farmers in Africa are not able to use quality seeds, quality input, good agriculture practices, leading to further reduction in productivity and hence reduction in profitability of the farmers. By putting right approach of climate resilient agriculture, local good agriculture practices, using biotic solution with high yielding seeds, extreme climate varieties, Africa can increase its productivity from currently low productivity of 3x lower than the potential for cereal, oil seeds, and it is 2x lower when it comes to pulses in horticulture. If Africa can produce as per its potential, it can feed 40% of world population. Now let us understand which are those economies where you see maximum potential. So if you see Ghana, Ghana is having huge capacity to produce crops, cash crops like cotton, pulses. It is having population of close to 29.7 million people, agriculture share is 18.3%, and $67 billion as a GDP. The next country is Nigeria. Nigeria is one of the largest economy in Africa. It is having 21.96% share of agriculture. With 195 million people, it itself is one of the big demand country for agriculture produce. Similarly, Ivory Coast, which is having 20% of its GDP coming from agriculture and GDP of $61.5 billion, is another country which can play a vital role as a strong agriculture economy of Africa. Then we are having Cameroon. Cameroon is more in crops, which are horticulture and cash crops, with the GDP of $38.63 billion and 16.7% of it coming from agriculture. Similarly, you have got Ethiopia. Ethiopia is one of the sunshine economy for agriculture in Africa. They started a little bit earlier than others to focus on agriculture. There is a huge possibility of Ethiopia going more than just being world's best coffee producing country. It is having GDP of $96 billion and 34.6% of that coming from agriculture. Flowers, vegetables and fruits can create more value for farmers in Ethiopia, and it is having agroclimatical zone to support that. Then we are having Rwanda, though a small country with GDP of $10.2 billion and 30.9% of that coming from agriculture. Rwanda is taking all right measures to create very vibrant agribusiness ecosystem. Kenya and Tanzania, two East African countries, which has already been on forefront of agriculture for past decade. With Kenya having GDP of $101 billion and with agri share of 34.5% is at point of inflection to become one of the largest food exporters from Africa. Similarly, Tanzania with GDP of $62.2 billion and agriculture having share of 26.4% out of that is also taking all right steps to create a vibrant horticulture driven agriculture ecosystem. These are some of the countries which are having consistent growth, political stability, as well as a market and capacity to leapfrog and make agriculture as a catalyst for growth. I hope you would have liked today's insightful AgriViews session. This session is brought to you by Honeybee. Honeybee works very closely with global agtech companies, agriculture ecosystem players, and help them to make Africa their next destination. Thank you. Take care.